Okay, so good day. So this time, we're going to solve our sample problem number 3. Again, under 3-moment equation. So as you can see from the given problem, we're asked to solve for the reactions of this indeterminate beam. If you can see at the figure, so we have a fixed support at A, hinge at B, hinge at C. So since there is no horizontal load naman dun sa beam, so we could just neglect the horizontal reactions at A, B, and C. Okay? So basically, we're asked to determine for the moment at A, reaction at A, moment at B, reaction at B, and reaction at C. Of course, the moment at C would be 0. Kasi nasa dulo siya ng beam, tas wala namang external moment applied at point C. So, there is a concentrated load of 40 kilonewtons applied at the midspan of AB and 5 kilonewton per meter uniform load on span BC. So, again, this is indeterminate to second degree. We can solve this by using 3-moment equation. Now, whenever you have a fixed support, okay, the fixed support, yung technique using 3-moment equation is to extend this on the left side with an imaginary span. So I call it as span OA. Span OA. This is imaginary. So the first 3-moment equation would be considering span OAB. Okay, so again, yung O is an imaginary point. The left side beyond the fixed support. So, ganyan ang parati natin gagawin whenever we have a fixed support. I-extend natin siya with an imaginary span. So, O, A, B, so 3 points uli. So, we could apply the 3-moment equation. Okay, so ano yung 3-moment equation dito sa O, A, B? So, that would be M, O, L, O, plus 2MA LO plus L1, then plus MB, then L1, okay, plus the 6AA over LO plus the 6AB over L1 is equal to what? Since point O, point A, and point B are unyielding supports, diba? Walang, hindi naman sila nagsettle or hindi naman siya nagyield. So, therefore, this would be just a 0. Okay? So, lagi siyang 0 kapag unyielding yung mga points yung mga supports. Okay, so this would be our first 3-moment equation. So, lahat na may imaginary length, it would just be 0. Okay, so imaginary length, this would be a 0. Okay, so di bali ang ano natin would be 2MA LO plus L1, LO is 0, so yung L1 is 4, so 4. Okay, plus MB times L1 is 4. Okay, then plus, eto 0 na to kasi this is corresponding to the length LO. So, wala naman yan. Imaginary yan. So, ito na lang. So, we have 6AB over L1 equals 0. Now, paano ulit pagkuha ng 6AB over L1? Okay, so let's see. 6AB over L1. So, ilabas ko muna yung 6 tsaka yung L1. Ang hanapin ko yung AB. Paano pagkuha ng A times B? Okay, so paano ulit gawin yun? Diba? For AB, this corresponds to L1. So, kopyahin mo yung L1. Kopyahin si L1. L1 is 4 meters. Okay, so 4 meters siya. Say, let ko siya sa L. Tapos gawin siyang simply supported. Parate, laging gawing simply supported. Tapos kopyahin yung load dun sa 4 meter length. So, meron tayong concentrated load na nasa midspan, 40. So, let this be as P, 40 kilonewton. And this is at midspan, so meaning this is 2 meters 2 meters, or that is L over 2, di ba? So this is L over 2, this is L over 2, 2 meters. Okay, now, so, paano sinosolve to? Pagka sinabing AB, we have to draw the area of the moment diagram by parts, tapos imumultiply mo yung area na yon with the centroid taken at B. Taken at B means to the right. So, yung reference mo ng centroid is measured to the right, B. Pagka AA naman kasi, moment area of the moment diagram multiplied by the distance of the centroid measured from the left. Yung small letter A dyan is measured from the left. Yung small letter B rito is measured from the right. So, yun lang yun, no? Since AB tayo, so sa right tayo mag-take ng distance. So, doon na rin ako mag-reference. So, in drawing the moment diagram by parts of this, doon na rin ako magre-reference. Okay, so of course, I need to solve for the reaction due to the 40 kilonewton. Since, this is nasa mid-span, so the reaction here would be P over 2. This is also P over 2. Okay, so i-generalize ko muna ito ah. So, hindi ko muna gagamitin yung mga given values. Okay, so with that, ito yung moment diagram by parts na, no? So, dito ang magre-reference. So, due to this P over 2, so ang moment diagram niyang by parts is diretsyong ganyan. First degree, P over 2 times L. So, that would be P L over 2. First degree. Tapos, itong P naman na nasa mid-span, ang moment diagram niyang by parts is here. So, that would be P times L over 2. That would be negative P L over 2. Okay, so ayan yung moment diagram by parts. Now, pag solve ng A times B, ulitin ko, yung A times B is yung area ng moment diagram, tapos yung B is the distance of the centroid measured from the right. B is on the right. So, yung unang triangle, yung malaking triangle, so that is 1 half, the base is L, and the height is PL over 2. Ito yung malaking triangle. Ang centroid niya is dito, sukat galing sa kanan. E di 1/3, di ba? So, 1/3 nung L. So, yan yung A. Ito yung area. Ito yung B. Small letter B. Distance ng centroid. Tapos, how about yung maliit na triangle sa ilalim? So, that would be plus 1/2. The base is L over 2. And the height of this triangle is negative PL over 2. Diba? Tapos, ito yung area, ano yung distance ng centroid niya measured from the right ulit. So, 1/3, diba? 1/3 of L over 2. So, yan yung value ng AB natin. So, pag sinimplify natin to, this would be PL cube over 2 times 2 is 4 times 3. No, okay, 4 times 3 is 12. Then, ito naman would be PL cube, negative PL cube, over 2 times 2 times 2, 4 times 2, 8, 8 times 3 is 24, times 2 is 48. So, this is 1 over 12. 1 over 12 minus 1 over 48. So, that is 1 over 16. Or PL cube over 16. So, yan yung value ng AB. Now, kung kukuhain natin yung buong value ng 6AB over L1. 6AB over L1. So, we have 6. AB is PL cube over 16. Over L1, yung L1 is yung L. Yan. So, this becomes, ano? Yung 6 tsaka 16, simplest form, that would be 3 over 8. So, 3 over 8 of PL, cancel yung isang L, naging PL square. Okay? So, di bali, yan yung value ng 6AB over L, which is 3PL square over 8. Kapag kayong concentrated load is nasa gitna. Okay? So, pagka sinubstitute natin dito, so this becomes what? So, 3 over 8 Ano yung P? P is 40, diba? So, 40. Yung L natin is 4 meters square. Okay, so this becomes... So, 3 over 8 times 40 times 4 square. So, we have 240 yung value natin ng 6AB over L1. Okay, so pagka-substitute natin lahat yan, substitute, so our equation becomes 2 times 4 is 8, 8MA plus 4MB plus this one is 240. Equal 0. So this would be our first three moment equation. From this first three moment equation, dalawang unknown, MA tsaka MB. So wala tayong masasolve so far, 'di ba? So ang gagawin natin is mag-generate ulit tayo ng another three moment equation para mapalabas natin yung MA tsaka MB. And how? That is considering the other next span. Okay, for the next span, let's say, this time let us consider span ABC naman. Span ABC. Okay, so three spans at a time. So span ABC. Ano ang three moment equation yan for span ABC naman? Kanina kasi OAB, diba? Dito naman ABC. Oh, this would be MA... L1 plus 2MB times L1 plus L2, okay, plus MC times L2 plus the 6AA over L1 plus the 6AB over L2 equals 0. Bakit 0? Kasi wala namang nagsettle na supports. Diba? A, B, C. Lahat sila, hindi naman nagsettle yung mga supports. So, 0 ang deflections nila. Okay. So, this would become MA, L1 is 4 meters, plus 2MB, L1 plus L2, 4 at saka 6. So, 4 plus 6. MC would be 0, right? A moment sa C is 0, dulo ng beam. So, 0. Plus, we have the 6AA over L1 plus the 6AB over L2 equals 0. Okay, so alamin natin yung 6AA tsaka 6AB. Okay, for 6AA over L1, 6AA over L1. Diba, this is referring to this span. Simple beam, gawin mong simple beam, tas kopyahin yung load. Yung load natin is 40 kilonewtons. Eh, hindi ba parehas yan dun sa dinerive natin kanina? Ito yun. No? So, I'll just copy, no? So, basta may concentrated load sa mid-span, ang 6AA niya, is just the same with the 6AB. Parehas lang. So, I'll just copy it as 3 PL square over 8. Okay? So, if you want, you could derive. Paano ginagawa to? Dito ka naman mag-reference sa A, sa left side. So, pagka nag-take ka ng moment about sa left side, ganyan din ang lalabas. Okay? So, substituting values, this would be 3 P is 40 times L natin is 4 meters square over 8. Okay, so that is actually equal to 240. Next, ano yung 6AB? Di tayo sa 6AB over L2. Paano pagkuha niyan? Okay, paano pagkuha na AB muna? Okay, paano ulit? Kopyahin yung length. Again, yung AB na to refers to the second span, diba? Ito yung 6 meters. Kopyahin yung length. So, yung length natin is 6 meters. Tapos, gawing simply supported beam. Tapos, kopyahin yung load. So, kunwari, ang load natin is, as you can see, uniform load. So, generalize natin as W. Okay. So, paano pagkuha ng AB? I-drawing mo yung moment diagram by parts nila. Tapos, mag-take ka ng moment area, moment of area about B. About B is sa right side naman. Okay. So, the reaction would be WL over 2. So, pag din-drawing ko yung moment diagram by parts nito, mag-reference ako dito, kunwari, sa right side. Due to that reaction, first degree. This would be WL over 2 times L. Kaya, WL square over 2. Tapos, due to the uniform load naman, the moment diagram would be spandrel of second degree. Ito, first degree. Ito, second degree. Anong magnitude ng point na to? Okay, that would be W times L over 2. So, W times L over 2. And that's negative kasi downward. Okay, so that is the moment diagram by parts. Now, para mo masolve yung AB, A times B, that's the area of the diagram times the distance of the centroid from B. From B is right side. Sa right side daw magtitake ng distance. Yung triangle muna. 1/2 base times height. Area ng triangle. Anong centroid niyan? Dito, distance from the right. So, 1/3 of L. O, yan yung sa triangle. Yan yung area. Yung small letter B, yun yung distance. Plus, how about dun sa spandrel na area? What's the area of the spandrel? 1 over 3. Okay, times L. Times negative WL square over 2. So, this is the area of the spandrel here. Nasaan yung centroid ng spandrel? Distance from the right. Diba? 1/4. Kung yung area, 1/3, yung centroid is 1/4. 1/4 of its L. So, therefore, pag sinimplify natin dyan, this would be WL to the 4th. WL to the 4th, nama ba? Okay. 2 times 2, 4 times 2, 8 over 8. So, yan yung sa triangle. And for the spandrel naman, it would be negative WL to the 4th over 3 times 2, 6, 6 times 4 is 24. So, therefore, this becomes 1/8 minus 1 over 24. No, so 1 over 12. So W L to the 4th over 12. So substituting it for 6AB over L, 6 W L to the 4th over 12 over L. So this becomes, yung 6 over 12 is, tas yung cancel yung isang L, W L cube over 1/8 minus, tama ba? 6, 24, 2, 4, 8. Teka, parang may mali. 1/2 base times height. Ah, sorry. This is 1/3. Sorry. This is 1/3. Sorry. This is 1/3. The area, the centroid distance of the triangle. 1/3 of L. While this is 1/4. Okay. So this would be 2 times 2 times 3. 4 times 3 is 12. So this should be 12. Sorry. Okay. 12. So therefore, this would be 1 over 12 minus 1 over 24. That would be 1 over 24. And this is, so this becomes 6 and 24. So that's over 4. And so generally, the value of the 6AB over L is just equal to WL cube over 4. Again, this is applicable kapag ka may uniform load ka sa full length nung unsupported length natin. WL cube over 4. So, substituting this value here, So our 6AB would be W is 5. The length is 6, 6 cube over 4. So our 6AB over L value becomes 5 times 6 cube over 4. So that's 270. Yan, 270. Oh, substitute natin yan dun. Dito. Substituting everything in this equation becomes 4MA. Dito tayo na. Plus 2 times 10 is 20. 20MB. Okay, plus this one. Ano to? This is 240. Plus itong 6AB is 270. Equals 0. So this would be our second equation. Okay, di yan. So meron tayong dalawang equations. First and second equations. With two unknowns, MA and MB. Solving simultaneous equations, we could solve for MA and MB. Okay? So paano? Halimbawa, times 2 ko to. Okay, so paano ko solve simultaneous? So pwedeng i-divide ko ng 2 to. So equation 1 divided by 2. So this equation 1, i-divide ko siya ng 2 lahat. So 8 divided by 2 is 4. 4MA plus 4 divided by 2. 4 divided by 2 is 2. 2MB. Tapos wait. This becomes 5, 5, 10. No, 5, 10 yung dalawa. Then, 240 divided by 2 is 120. Plus 120 equals 0. So, i-minus ko yung equation 2 with this revised equation 1. So, this would be 0. 20 minus 2 is 18. 18MB. 5, 10 minus tama. 240 plus 270, 510 minus 120, 390 plus 390 equals 0. Therefore, our MB is equal to negative 390 divided by 18. 21, or in fraction para sakto, 65 over 3. Or that's 21.6667. That's kilonewton, negative meter. So yan yung moment sa B. Okay. So okay na yung moment sa B natin. How about for moment sa A? So substitute natin. Substitute value of MB in either equation 1 or equation 2, either ways. No? So say, so in equation 1 natin, our MB, MA will become, so our MB is negative 65, ito yun. Okay, so times 4 plus 240, okay, lipat na sa kabila, divide by 8, so it would be negative. Negative 115 over 6, or that is in decimal, negative 19.1667 kilonewton meter. Okay, so that is the moment at A. Okay, so we're done with the moments at A and B. So how about for the reactions? So how do we do reactions? Okay, so alam na natin yung mga moments sa A, moments sa B, moments sa C, 0. So, paano pag-solve ng RA, RB, RC? So, masasolve yon by sections. O, paano yung pag-sections? Isolate tayo. So, isolate Member, ano ba? BC. Kunwari, member BC. Kapag in-isolate natin si member BC, okay, ito yung RC. Tapos ito yung uniform load. Puputulin lang natin siya bago mag-support sa B. So, ito yun. So, may shear dyan. Shear sa B, sa right side. Tapos may moment din siya. Itong uniform load is 5 kN per meter. And the length is 6 meters. Anong moment ulit sa B? Anong moment natin sa B? Moment natin sa B is negative 21. So, negative. So, paano direction yan? Clockwise or counterclockwise? Negative means sad face. So, para maging sad face to, paano direction ng moment? Pag ganun, diba? Para mag-sad face siya, mag-sad face. So, this should be the correct direction ng negative 21 sad face. So, ito yung 65 over 3 na moment sa B. Yan na yung direction niya. So, since hindi ko alam yung shear sa B, doon ako magmo-moment sa A, sa B. Summation of moment ako sa B equals 0. Let's say, clockwise are positive moments. So, pag nag-moment ako sa B, meron akong counterclockwise yung 65 over 3, negative 65 over 3. Negative 65 over 3. Tapos yung uniform load, clockwise. So, plus 5 times 6 times 3. Tapos yung RC, pa-counterclockwise, minus RC times 6 equals 0. So, from here, masasolve ko yung RC. Negative 65 over 3 plus 5 times 6 times 3 divided by 6. So, we have 11.3889 kilonewtons. Positive, that means tama yung direction natin. So, yan yung RC. Okay? Now, paano magkuha ng reaction sa B? Ang gawin mo naman is whole structure na tayo. Whole beam. Say yung ABC. Okay, for the whole beam ABC, oh, tingnan nyo to. For the whole beam ABC, alam mo na yung RC, diba? Alam mo na yung RC. RC is 205 over 18. 205 over 18. So, yun yung 11.3888. So, paano ma-solve yung RB? Eh, di mag-moment ka naman. So, take moment tayo sa A. Sa whole structure. Let's say, clockwise is positive. Okay. Yung moment sa A natin kanina yung negative 90. Negative, so that is sad face. So, isabihin, tama ang direction natin ng moment dito is counterclockwise. And this is 115 over 6 yung MA. Okay? So, we take moment at A. So, ano yung mga equation natin? So, negative MA, negative counterclockwise. So, negative 115.6. Okay? Itong 40 plus 40 times 2 yung RB minus RB times 4 uniform load plus 5 times 6 times 3 plus 4, 7. Then last RC, minus RC, 205 over 18. Anong moment arm ng RC? 10 times 10. Everything should be equal to 0. So from here, I could solve for R, B. Plus 5 times 6 times 7 minus 205 over 18 times 10. Tapos ito sa right side, divide by 4. So our RB natin is 39.2361 kilonewton. Positive, that means pataas, tama ang direction. Ayan na. Ano pa? Huli, RA. So, again, for the whole beam, ABC, summation of forces vertical naman tayo equal to 0. Okay? So, paano? O, whole structure. Ito, whole structure. Let's say, pataas are positive. So, ano yung mga forces vertical based from the whole structure? So, RA pataas, 40 pababa, RB pataas plus RB, 39.2361. Tapos yung uniform load pababa, 5 times 6. Tapos yung RC pataas, 205 over 18 equals 0. So, from there, I could solve for RA. 39 minus 40 minus 5 times 6 plus 205 over 18. Tapos lipat sa kabila, so positive. That would be positive 19.375 kilonewton. So these are the reactions now. These are the moments, MAMB, and these are the reactions, A, B, and C. Okay, so tapos na tayo. So, ganyan ang pag so solve ng indeterminate beam using three-moment equation. So, I hope you learn out of this, something about out of this. Thank you.